about the public comments made by the Hong Kong and Macau Affairs Office and the Central People's Government Liaison Office in Hong Kong. I want to refute categorically any accusation that such comments made by the two offices constitute interference, especially when some critics refer to Basic Law Article 22. I see no ground for that sort of accusation. As I have explained, from the constitutional perspective, one has to fully understand that under one country, two systems, yes, through the system and through the basic law, the central authorities have given Hong Kong a high degree of autonomy. But that doesn't mean that the central government has given up its power and authority on Hong Kong affairs. And the central government has always been very supportive of Hong Kong SAR government's work in terms of improving livelihood and also promoting Hong Kong's economic development. So when they see this very bizarre situation, when the Legislative Council is almost malfunctioning because the House Committee has not been able to elect a chairman for over 6 months, I find it only legitimate for them to express their concern. So there's absolutely no ground for accusation of interference by the two offices. If you look at the from the governance perspective, the Legislative Council has very clear functions under the Basic Law, including the making of legislation, including the receiving of complaints from the people of Hong Kong, including a debate on the Chief Executive's policy address. And many of these functions have not been discharged since October last year because of the way that someone has handled the election of the House Committee Chairman. And this has gone on for 6 months. So this is really unacceptable. So that means that it will certainly affect the things that we want to do, which we are doing, of course, for the people of Hong Kong. Thirdly is from the operational level. It is for all to see that after a period of malfunctioning, a lot of government business, especially in legislation, has been helped up by the House Committee not having its proper function and operation for so long. And many of these legislation have a direct impact on Hong Kong's economic development and the livelihood of the people. So this is a very unfortunate event and a very undesirable phenomenon, which we should all try to rectify as soon as possible. The difficulties of governance in Hong Kong are for all to see. I would say that the Hong Kong SAR government would have a much easier life in this anti-epidemic work if we have more cohesiveness in society, more unity, more solidarity, putting aside our political differences for the time being, in order to help Hong Kong to go out of this epidemic as soon as possible.